about to test which one has more of 40 milliliters and what one has 40 less milliliters.
Which glass is more full? The game seems simple, but I promise that you will get it wrong. This here is an elongated skull from Peru. It's a cast of an elongated skull from Peru. I recently showed it off in a video on Nikolai Baluyev. There's a bunch of people on the internet trying to claim that he is a Neanderthal, an evolutionary leftover from the past. And no, that's not what's going on. That video gained me a bunch of new subscribers, and lots of people were asking about this elongated skull that I showed off briefly in that video. So the claim being made about these is that these elongated skulls are not humans. There's a guy named Brian Forrester who's made a living doing this.
I doubt that the ancestors of these people are what we call Homo sapiens.
He's not claiming that these are aliens. He claims that they are not Homo sapiens. And he says there's a couple reasons for that. He says they're lacking a sagittal suture. They've got little holes on the back of the head. And he said that they are 25% larger. Now, I've done a video that covers each of these claims. I highly recommend that you watch that. It really does look, if you look at this skull, that it's 25% larger. If you measure from here to the top, it's about 25% larger. But it's also narrower on the sides and on the front and on the back. And so when you actually measure the volume, well, I don't want to spoil it for you. I want you to actually see for yourself. There are links down in the video description to videos where my nephew and I measure this skull. There are links to videos where people in Peru are measuring the craziest specimens that exist. Brian Forrester has made a living tricking people about these skulls, and it's very easy for him to do this because people are horrible at judging volume by eye. To demonstrate just how bad we are at this, Jackson and I came up with a little game show. Can you accurately judge the volume of these different glasses, these different beer mugs? And poor Jackson, he had just gotten new glasses and they had been hurting his eyes. We filmed this video years ago and we posted it in little segments and it did not do well. I think because of the way it was cut up into multiple segments that you had to watch at different times, at different days. For all of the new people who just subscribed, I have edited it down to one single video and here it is for you to enjoy.
This is an experiment to see which cup is more full. And which one is what has less?
I filled all these with 400 milliliters of water. Then I took 40 milliliters. This is 40 milliliters right here. I took 40 milliliters out of one of them. And then I poured that into one of the other ones. So one of these cups is missing 40 milliliters. And one of these cups has an extra 40 milliliters. Now, just so you know, the coloring here has nothing to do with anything. I did the coloring afterwards. The cups are different shapes, just like these two skulls are different shapes. And human beings are super bad at judging volume. That is how much space something takes up. We're super bad at judging with our eyes. And because of that, they'll look at this and say, oh, it's an alien because it looks bigger than this normal skull. But really it's because they're bad at judging volume with their eyes. But before we do the experiment, Jackson, we've made a mistake. We are trying to teach people stuff on the internet. When they watch their conspiracy theory shows on TV, all the people are dressed up like scientists.
Ooh. We should go to Target and buy some, should we? What the heck? How did you do that?
I think that we might be a little bit, this might be a little bit overkill. What do you think?
Yeah, if you ask me, it looks a little overkill.
Yeah, let's lose the mask. Yeah. Maybe the head. Should I keep the glasses? Are the glasses cool?
The glasses I'm supposed to wear anyway, so.
Which one of these is fuller? Which one is less full? And this is number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In the YouTube comments, write less equals, and then choose your number. And then write more equals, and then choose your number. Pause and do that right now. No cheating. No skipping ahead. Pause the video and put your numbers now.
Hello, everyone back. I hope you are, because we're about to test which one has more of 40 milliliters and what one has 40 less milliliters.
Exactly. Now, Jackson, You did not see which one has more and which one has less. I want to get your guess before
yes,
we
I was
do.
Mario Maker.
Yeah, Jackson was watching Mario Maker while I set this all up, so he doesn't know which one has less and which one has more. So what's your guess? Which one has the least amount of water in it?
Actually,
colored water. You think the green one has less? All right. Which one has 40 milliliters extra?
No, this one has extra. This one has less.
This one has less? This one has extra?
Yep.
Let's test and find out. We've got our trusty beaker right here.
Yep.
Set that aside so we don't spill it.
Number one. Bye-bye. It's going to turn into a black
stuff. Now, if it's normal, it should just read 400. What does that read?
That reads 400, pretty much.
Number one was just regular. If you guessed that, sorry, you're wrong. Okay. Number two.
Let's go.
What do you think it's gonna be?
What?
Number two was less. Number two was 40 milliliters less. 40 milliliters short of 400. Look at that. So if you guessed that number two was less full, you were correct. Yay! At least partially correct. You still have to get the other one as well.
Ooh,
number three.
The entire color.
Number three. It's purple one.
Purple.
What do we got?
240.
You mean 400?
Oh, wait, 400.
400 milliliters. It's just regular, normal. Number three was normal. So number two had less. Number three was normal. Number one was normal.
Ugh. What did I get that? Looks like toxic sludge.
Yeah, it's fine.
That's just toxic sludge, even worse.
What do you think?
400.
400. Again. Number four. That was number four, right? Yeah, number four is normal.
I got none of them right.
All right, now we got number five. What do you think?
Probably not.
Number five. Jackson, I happen to know.
Dun, dun, dun.
There's something special about this one.
It is above
440 milliliters.
Jeez.
Number five was the full one. It's important now that you're able to see me measure all of the other cups as well, so you can make sure that I'm not cheating. Here I've muted us and I'm speeding things up so you don't have to sit through all of this, but you can check and see for yourself the measurements of each cup. When I first uploaded this video, I gave people a week to play before I revealed the answers. I'm going to show you their results, but first to tell if they did good or not. If they did better than random, let's do a little bit of math and figure out what random would be. If you, dear audience, happened to be a bunch of monkeys choosing glasses at random, what would your odds be? Well, there are 9 cups, so getting the first one right is a chance of 1 out of 9. And then because one of those has already been chosen, the odds of getting the second one right, assuming you got the first one right, are 1 in 8. So to find the chance of getting both correct in a row, we need to multiply the fractions. That's 1/9 times 1/8 is 1 in 72. It would take, on average, 72 monkeys to play this game in order for one of them to be statistically likely to get it right, to win. Well, did my human viewers do better than my hypothetical monkeys? Nope. Not even close. 89 people played, and every single one of them got it wrong. In fact, one person, Miss Roshen, somehow managed to get it perfectly wrong. Now, don't worry. This is actually really hard to do. I could really make a killing with this if I turned it into a carnival game. Maybe I should do that. But I guess that technically there was one guy that you could say got it right. He said, "I don't know." That was his answer. And that, you know, that was technically correct. So congratulations to you, sir. Now, one of the things I want to point out, too, is that it's hard to do this when you're here, when you're in person. It's even harder to do it on the internet, looking through the TV or through your monitor or through your phone at a video. And that is one of the reasons that these alien conspiracy theory people have so much success, It's because people can't actually see these with their eyes in real life. There's all sorts of perspective games. It's really hard to tell how big something is when you're looking at it on TV.